Hello class 12, here I will give you more examples on 1-1 function. Next, fx equals to x square plus x plus 1 and f n to n. So here domain is natural number and codomain is also natural number. So first I will start, let x1, x2 belongs to n, means natural number. So we can write fx1 equals to fx2. And from here we can say that x1 square plus x1 plus 1 equals to x2 square plus x2 plus 1. So after that we can write x1 square minus x2 square plus x1 minus x2 equals to 0. And if I will factorize this, I will get x1 plus x2 into x1 minus x2. So from here take common x1 minus x2. So what will be left here? x1 plus x2 plus 1 equals to 0. I am repeating once more. Here just factorize a square minus b square formula. That means a plus b into a minus b. So from there I have taken common x1 minus x2. What is left? x1 plus x2, x2 plus 1 equals to 0. Now, from the second part, it is clear that for no natural number, this one will be followed. Take any natural number. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. 1 plus 2. So, plus 1 is also there. 0 is not a natural number, we know. So, for any x1, x2 being natural numbers, this condition will be not followed. So here I have to write that, first copy this one, then you will write, since x1, x2 belongs to n, means natural number, therefore x1 plus x2 plus 1 not equals to 0. If it is real number, then this one will be followed. But since natural numbers x1 and x2, so this one will be not followed. So what is the only condition here? From here, I will only get x1 minus x2 equals to 0. So I will write it here. Therefore, x1 minus x2 equals to 0 and implies x1 equals to x2. So previously, I have taken fx1 equals to fx2. From there, I have proved that x1 equals to x2. So since fx1 equals to fx2 implies x1 equals to x2, that means this function is 1-1. So after that we will write this, that since fx1 equals to fx2 implies x1 equals to x2, therefore f is 1-1 function. Now next example. What is given here? If from whole number to whole number, the function is n plus 1 when n is even, n minus 1 when n is odd. So here I have to take three cases. When both the numbers are odd, both the numbers are even, or when one of them is odd and another one is even. So first I have taken both the numbers are odd. n1 is odd and n2 is also odd. So I will start from f of n1 equals to f of n2. So f of n1, that means it will be n1 minus 1 equals to n2 minus 1, because n minus 1 when n is odd, so cancel both of them, you will get n1 equals to n2. I have taken f n1 equals to f n2, I have got n1 equals to n2. So when both the numbers are odd, at that time, f will be 1-1. Now next, I will take when both of them are even. First, copy this one. Next, when both the cases are even here, so if n1 equals to fn2, that means even means n1 plus 1 equals to n2 plus 1. So I will cancel both of them. Here also n1 equals to n2. Now next I will take when one of them is even and another one is odd. So if I will take this one, that means take any one of them is even. So I have taken n1 as even and n2 as odd. Then what will happen? So first I will write f of n1 equals to f of n2. Now n1 is even, so it will be n1 minus 1 equal, sorry, n1 plus 1, and n2 is odd, so it will be n2 minus 1. Now think it properly. If n1 is even and n1 plus 1 will be odd, because we know that if one number is even, just the number after that will be odd. Similarly, if n2 will be odd, so the previous number will be even, because n2 minus 1, I am repeating once more. If n1 is even number, so n1 plus 1 means this one will be odd. If n2 is even number, sorry, n2 is odd number, then n2 minus 1, so that will be even. And we know that odd numbers and even numbers never be equal. So this one is completely wrong. That means f n1 not equals to f n2. So implies that f n1 not equals to f n2. That means, and n1 and n2 both are different. I have assumed that first. So, if n1 and n2 both are different, and we have also proved that fn1 and fn2 both are different, that means it is also 1-1. So, two conditions are there. Number 1, I will take fx1 equals to fx2, then I will prove x1 equals to x2. Number 2, I will take x1 not equals to x2, then I will prove fx1 not equals to fx2. So here I have taken the second one. N1 and N2 both are different here, since even and odd. So both are not same. So I have taken two different numbers, and then I have proved that the images are not same. So it will be obviously 1-1. And if you will take N1 as odd and N2 as even, this will be same. So case 1, it was N1 equals to N2. Case 2, it was also n1 equals to n2. And case 3, I have taken two different numbers. I have got two different images. So after that, we will write, therefore, f is 1-1 function. Now the next one. Fx equals to x by 1 plus mod x. And f r 2, x such that minus 1 less than x less than 1. Now this one is the codomain, and it is, sorry, it is the is this codomain, and this one is domain. So R2 minus 1 less than x less than 1. Now first case I have taken that both the numbers are greater than 0. You know that whenever modulus will be there, so I have to separate in two cases. One will be greater than equals to 0, and another one will be less than 0. So here I have taken x1 and x2, both are here greater than 0. So here also you can take greater than equals to 0. Now I have started from fx1 equals to fx2. Replace the value. fx1 means x1 by 1 plus x1, because when x is positive or 0, then mod x will be x. That's why when x1 is positive, then mod of x1 will be x1 itself. So 1 plus x1, and here also, since x2 is also 0 or positive, I have taken x2 by 1 plus x2. Now cross multiply. After that I have got x1 equals to x2. Now next case 2 you will do. That means both of them you will take less than 0. And do similarly. Third one you will take 1 positive and 1 negative. Okay. So case 2 and case 3, you will finish yourself when you will submit the copy. Then I will check this one. Please finish this sum yourself.